Hi, welcome to the channel NCERT Maths Tutor. In this video, we will discuss Chapter 1 Relation and Function, Class 12 Mathematics, in that composition of function. Composition of function means here we can combine two functions or more than two functions together, which we call as the composition of function. So consider two functions. So here I have taken a function f which is defined from a to b and a function g which is defined from b to c. So for the function f, domain is a and codomain is b. For the function g, domain is b and codomain is c. Now if we combine these two functions together, then we can call the composition of f and g as GOF or GOF, where for this we can have the domain of f as a and codomain as codomain of g function as c. So GOF, which is defined from a to c, and that we write as GOF is equal to GOFX, that is equal to G of fx for all x belongs to A. See here, this is known as the composition of F and G, where here you can observe that the domain of the composition of GOF is nothing but the domain of the function F, and codomain of the composition function is the codomain of the function G. So first function is combined with the second function. So we can represent this as GOF, which is nothing but G of fx. In the same way, we can have a fog, fog, which we write as f of g of x. So these two types of compositions are possible with respect to the function. See, GOF and fog are entirely different. GOF is not equal to fog. Here, in the case of GOF function, we take the input value of the f function. So first here, the f function is performed first, after that g function is performed. Whereas in the case of fog, here we take the input of the g function. So first g function is performed, after that f function is applied. So that is the difference between GOF and fog. So here let us understand the same thing by referring the diagram. I have taken three sets A, B and C. So first let us consider A and B set. In this set there is a function f is defined, where this f function takes the input. In the A set, let us say that we have some inputs and that input is nothing but x. Then that x is mapped to the B set element, which we represent as f of x or fx. So this forms the function f. Then next, one more function is defined, that is a g function, which is defined from b to c. So here we have a b set and c set. In the b set we have set of elements. These set of elements are nothing but the, these are the output of the function f, or these are the range values of the function f, which we denote as fx. So for the g function, we take the domain value as the range of f, that is fx. Then that is mapped to the set C, that is g of fx. See here, if the input is x, we write f of x for the f function. Now for the g function, input is fx, so we write that as g of fx. Now this forms, that is from x to c, this forms the composition of the function, which we call as GOF or GOF or g of fx. In this case, in the case of g of fx, first here f function is applied, after that g function is applied. So that is about the composition of the function, and always GOF is not equal to fog. Let us understand this by taking an example. See here I have taken fx is equal to x square and gx is equal to x plus 1. Now let us find out GOF and fog. So first here GOF, which is nothing but GOFX, that is g of fx. Here whenever we are finding the g of fx, first we have to perform the fx function. So we have fx function and then we have a g function. See, inside the g function we have the value as x plus 1. So wherever you have x, that you have to replace as fx. That means for the g function, we are taking now fx as input. So in the place of x, you have to write fx. So fx plus 1. and fx value is x square, that gives x square plus 1. Next, let us find out fog, that is fog. Fog x or f of g x, in this case, inside the f function, we are taking the input of function g, that is g of x. So, in the f x function, wherever you have x, that you have to replace by g x. So, we have here g x whole square. Then we know the value of g x, that is x plus 1. So, we get here x plus 1 whole square. Now, you can observe that gof is not equal to fog. We got here x square plus 1 and here we got x plus 1 whole square. So, gof value is not equal to fog. This you can even understand by referring the diagram. See, in this case, we have defined the fx function as x square. That means, let us say that in the A set, I have taken 1, 2, 3, 4, these 4 values. Then fx is x square. That means here we get 1 square, 2 square is 4, 3 square is 9, and 4 square is 16. So, this forms our fx function. After that, we have the gx function, that is x plus 1, and this for this gx function, whatever the value we have in the range of fx, that we take as an input. That means, see, this forms the range of the function fx now. In this particular range becomes the input value or the domain value for the g function. So now, for the g function, this we are taking as the domain value. And g function is x plus 1. That means 1, if we have here, then 1 plus 1, that is 2, then x plus 1, 4 plus 1, 5, 9 plus 1, 10, 16 plus 1, that is 17. Then next here, the gof function. Gof function is nothing but x square plus 1. So here, this and this, if you connect, that is a and c, that forms the gof, that is g of fx. Here you can observe, here we have x square plus 1, which is nothing but, see, in this case, we have, if the input is 1, we get here 1 square plus 1, that is 2. If the input is 2, 2 square, that is 4 plus 1, that is 5. If the input is 3, 3 square is 9, 9 plus 1, that is 10. 4 square, that is 16, 16 plus 1, that is 17. So, you can clearly observe that this forms the g of fx or gof function. In the similarly, we can have a fog, but for that fog, again, you have to define one more set and that you have to connect. So, that is about the gof and fog. Next here, let us take another example. Here, see, in this example, we have taken two functions and but we can take one single function and we can perform the composition of that function with itself. That is also possible in the case of composition of function. Let us see how to do that. See, here I have taken fx is equal to x plus 2. Now, if I want to combine this function with itself, then we can write that as fof or f o fx, which is nothing but f of fx. Here, first of all, in the fx function, wherever you have x, that you have to replace with fx. So, now we have fx plus 2. Then we know the value of fx, that is x plus 2. That value you have to put here. So, x plus 2 plus 2, that gives the answer x plus 4. So, like this way, you can perform the composition of the function, that is with itself, that is nothing but fof. Then next here, let us see the third example. See, here I have taken directly the numbers and let us see with respect to numbers how we can find out the gof and fog. So, here there are two functions. F is a function which is defined from 2, 3, 4 to 5, 6, 7 and g is a function which is defined from 5, 6, 7 to 3, 4, 3. And for the f function, the values are given f of 2 is 5, f of 3 is 6, f of 4 is 7, g of 5 is 3, g of 6 is 4, g of 7 is 3. Now, let us find out gof and fog. So, first here we will find out the gof value. See, whenever we are finding the gof value or g of fx, first here we have to consider the f function. So, whatever the domain values we have in the f function, that we have to consider here. In this case, for the f function, we have the domain values 2, 3, 4. So, these values you have to substitute in this place now. So, g of f of 2, g of f of 3, g of f of 4. For these values, you need to find out the answer. So, let us find out that. So, g of f of 2. See, f of 2 is 5 here. So, g of 5. G of 5 is 3. So we got the answer G of f of 2 is equal to 3. Next, G of f of 3. F of 3 is 6 here. So G of 6 is equal to 4. Next, G of f of 4. That is f of 4 value 7 here. So G of 7 is equal to 3. So now for the GO function, we can have a new domain and codomain value as domain we can take as 2, 3, 4. For this, the domain is nothing but the f function domain, that is 2, 3, 4. And for the codomain, we got the answer 3, 4, 3, that is 3, 4, 3. So this way, you can define the domain and codomain of the GO function. And you can write the ordered paste like this way, 2, 3. For 2, you get 3. So 2, 3. For 3, 3, 4. Then 4, 3. So like this way, you can define the GO function. Next here, let us define the values for the fog. See, whenever we are finding the fog or f of g of x, first here you have to apply the value, the domain values of the g function. So first here we have a g function. So whatever the input values you are taking for the g function, domain values you are taking, that you have to consider. So in the g function, we have the domain values as 5, 6, 7. So that value you have to take here. So f of g of 5, f of g of 6, f of g of 7, these values we need to find out. So first let us find out that f of g of 5, g of 5 is 3, so f of 3 is 6. Then f of g of 6 value is 4, so f of 4 is 7. F of g of 7 value is 3, so f of 3 is 6. So here we got the new function, composition function as fog. That is, for that we have the domain as 5, 6, 7, and then we have the codomain value as 6, 7, 6. See, here you can see that one thing, in the case of GO function, the domain value becomes the domain of the f and codomain value becomes the codomain of the g function. Whereas in the case of for function, the domain value is the domain of the g function, but the codomain is a different set. That is the reason that, see, when we consider this diagram, see here I have shown you the GO function. For the GO function, domain becomes the a set and codomain becomes the c set. That is the domain of the f and codomain of the g function. Whereas for the fog function, the domain is the B set, but the codomain is the new set. So like this way, we can have a GO and fog function. So this is about the composition of the function. If you like this video, please like and subscribe. Thanks for watching.